Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar coming to you from Colorado in my home office. And like the title says, before you pass on any story, good or bad, make sure you've checked it. Now, I see a trend going on because social media is the best way to pass a story on and make it go viral than I've ever seen in my life. But I've seen more stories that are not true now than I ever have in my life, and especially in this political season. It's totally amazing. And what I suggest to you is before you pass on a story that looks true, but you don't know, especially I have to say this, especially from all the media news, because the majority of them are not telling the truth. It's really sad to say that, but that is what they do now. Instead of telling truth, they fabricate stories and they just count on you passing it on. And when you pass it on, you're hurting your credibility. And I've had somebody even call me out on that. So, yeah, I've learned. You want to make sure. Go and look for the source of where that story actually came from. For instance, if they share a video, go and click on the video, find out who actually posted that video. Was that person a credible person? Was that somebody that is known to tell the truth, or was that somebody that was known to tell a lie? Or, was it a newscaster that just looks for ways to pass on some viral information that doesn't have any truth behind it? Typical of that is just today, just today they put out that Trump is encouraging people to go and shoot Clinton. That is absolutely not the truth. I saw that actual footage of real live video when he said it, and it was not intended that way. But the news will actually go and say it because they don't like Trump. You know what? I don't care if you like him or you don't like him. I'm not telling you to vote for him or not vote for him, but I am telling you to please go check out the source. I see a whole bunch of websites all over the place lately that most of it is not very complimentary to him. And I think that is the major reason why so much of that is produced. And their main objective is actually to get you to share it. So before you go get excited about a headline, go and find out if it's the truth. Because it does hurt you if you keep sharing stuff that isn't the truth. I try to find the actual YouTube. I watch the whole thing. Then I go and check and find a couple of more sources first to see if it actually has truth in it. If it doesn't, I'm not going to share it. It's so important not to do that. It hurts you in your business. And I did it to myself for one piece of information that I shared. So definitely, definitely take more time. This is one of those times in this hit. This is bigger than I've ever seen in my life, history-wise, that social media plays a huge part in making or breaking not just political candidates, but even your own business. You want to be credible and you want to be honest, and so you need to make sure you check what you are sharing. And that can also be to have to do with your own business. Are you sharing fact or are you sharing somebody's story that isn't actually backed up with fact? Be absolutely careful what you share because you know what? A lot of people see it, even if you delete it. So it's a really good idea to check it out. And I did catch myself in doing that one time. So I'm being a lot more cautious about what I share so that I want to make sure I'm being honest and I'm being factual, even if the source wasn't necessarily. And sometimes I'll share something that isn't the truth, and then I'll back it up with my own opinion and tell you what I believe, and you can take it or leave it. I think that helps people to understand. And one thing that I realized, and I'm seeing it all over now, you go to a concert or whatever, and you see people with their phone up and they're actually recording an event. You can't really hide things that are not, that are the truth very long, and you can't hide what's been hyped or been stretched out of proportion very long, because there's a lot of people out there that are doing live video, which is awesome. I think it's cool because now we're becoming reporters. We're becoming the truth seekers ourselves, and I think that's very important to do. I saw somebody, I don't know if I can find it now, it's on my timeline somewhere, that somebody that was actually at the Democratic convention, you know, what was it, 2 years, 2 weeks ago or so, when they did that, and she was showing something about something that was not cool that was going on, and she actually had video footage of the real event and the real, you know, thing that was going on. So when you find somebody that's actually shared the truth, almost always it's going to be kind of not so perfectly put together. Usually that's a pretty good sign that it may not be the truth if you think about it. So make sure, check your sources. Don't be like these newspaper and CNN and all of them that are telling absolute lies. Don't be like them. Go and check things out, find out the real truth, then share it before you share it. And some of these websites, I have to say, are actually not pro-Trump. If you're one of my friends that loves Trump, check it out first before you share it so that you can make sure that it's really the truth. I think that will help you, and it helps all of us too. I hope that helps you. You can find me at successwithlyndacromar.com. That's my blog. And get on my newsletter at marketingnewswithlynda.com. I'll share that now. Bye for now. And that's marketingnewswithlynda.com. Bye for now.